Coming up on UPC, senior breakfast tickets are on sale.
On my right and on my left are two people. I'll tell you who they are and what they're doing here during the show.
Prom was a success. All this and more is coming up on UPC, and it starts right now.
Were they?
Hilarious, really.
Hello and welcome to the Monday, May 14th edition of the UPC Morning Show. I'm Katie Cosper.
And I'm Ashley Barlow. Mr. Kell and the prom committee would like to thank everyone who helped to make prom 2001 a success last Saturday night. The grace and good manners displayed by the students of Countryside High School impressed everyone, from the Harborview staff to the police officers who provided security. They would also like to express their gratitude to the chaperones for taking their time to help supervise the event. Without everyone, prom 2001 would not have been as possible. Also, if anyone who attended prom did not get a prom favor, or if their prom favor broke, they have a few extras. Also, if anyone is missing anything after prom, please see Mr. Kell in F1 for lost and found. Prom committee members will have a short meeting Thursday to wrap up this year's event. Mu Alpha Theta will have an election of officers meeting today in room B2 at 2 o'clock.
Seniors who would like to win a $500 scholarship need to see Mrs. Guthrie today to pick up an application. One senior from CHS will be chosen. Interested seniors will need to write a 500-word essay on what teamwork means to me. Applications are due by Friday. Seniors who missed homeroom on Wednesday, April 25th, may pick up their gowns and other graduation materials from their sponsor in room D5. Seniors who have yet to order a cap and gown must also see Mr. Straub immediately. Please stop by between classes.
All faculty, the lockdown procedure sheet given out at the Thursday faculty meeting should be placed in your grade book for the remainder of the school year. If you need another, see Mr. Marn in L1. If you did not pick up your graduation announcement order during lunch on April 25th, please pick them up in D5. Additional announcements are $1, tassels are $5.35, and a limited number of original class of 2001 t-shirts are $10 are also available.
Senior Breakfast 2001 tickets are on sale today, May 14th. Bring your completed permission form and $25 cash to the main office during lunch. Maps to Innisbrook Resort will be available. There will be a meeting for any freshman, sophomore, and junior interested in playing on the golf team next year, Wednesday, May 16th at 2 p.m. in room D6.
9th and 10th graders who have participated in two sports and are wanting to weigh personal fitness and their PE elective will need to pass the personal fitness exam. The date has been changed from this Saturday to next Wednesday at 2 o'clock. Interested students need to see Ms. Guthrie and guidance to sign up. Ms. Collins will be going to review sessions next week on Monday and Wednesday in H1. Textbooks can be checked out from any of the personal fitness teachers. There will be a battle of the bands on May 19th at Pier 60 from 6 to 9 p.m. This entertainment is free and NSYNC tickets will be raffled off. And now let's go to John with an interview on drama.
All right, thank you, Ashley. I'm here with Joey Sarlow and Amy Spur, who are representing the drama department, who this week they're putting on another amazing theatrical performance of Godspell. Joey, can you tell me a little about Godspell?
Yeah, Godspell is one of the most popular musicals ever produced on and off Broadway. It's filled with a lot of dancing, a lot of rock music. We've got a four-piece band that'll be there, and just a lot of fun stuff. It'll be well worth your time to come out and see what's going on.
All right, thanks. And Amy, when are the showtimes, and how can I get tickets to attend these showtimes?
Well, the show is this Wednesday through Saturday at 7:30 in the auditorium, and you can get tickets. You can either just come down to the auditorium, or you can just get them the night of the show.
All right, sounds great. Thank you for the interview, and back to the news desk.
Thanks, John. There's an opportunity to hold a dual-credit English composition class. Waiting for the teleprompter to roll. Here at CHS after school fall, the class will be meeting one afternoon per week for 3 hours. So the credit received will be an elective credit. Ms. Saginario would like to know if there's enough interest in this class. Please stop by her office by next Tuesday if you are interested. The Tampa federal EEO is pleased to give its first scholarship to a member of the 2001 Pinellas County High School graduating class. Interested seniors must have at least a 2.5 GPA, maximum family income of $75,000, and be able to write a 250-word essay. Please see Mrs. Guthrie for an application. These applications must be postmarked no later than May 21st.
Congratulations to Countryside High's creative writers, the Largo Library, recognized the finalists of their 17th annual short story contest on Thursday evening, and 9 of the 13 winners from CHS. The following students receive honorable recognition: Salome Blignot, Elena Bresky, Audrey Hamm, Carolyn Langs, Alicia Mann, Ashley Mesmore, and Michael Ross was named third place winner. Kristen Gubser was named second place winner, and the first place prize went to Ashley Conrad.
And the Palm Harbor Library Youth Advisory Board will be hosting a teen town hall on Thursday, May 17th at 7 p.m. in the library's community room. This is your chance to speak out on issues important to you and your community. A panel of local officials will be there to answer your questions and listen to your concerns. For more information, call Mitzi at 784-3332. Don't miss this chance to make a difference. And that's all we have. Have a great week.